go and take an engine room round and see different kinds of all players at different positions, and I'll tell you, give you an example. Jai Mata Di guys. So let's start with the glow ball. Guys, this is a glow ball first of all. Theek hai? And it's a straight glow ball. See that? Yahan se flow is coming and flow is going out from here. Now over here, this direction is mentioned over here. Ki whenever you put, you have to put ki bhaiya flow yahan se yahan par aaye. Along with that, you can see something is written over here. It is written PN16. It is 16 and DN15. That means 16 bar tak ka pressure it can hold and 50 is the bore diameter over here. Come now, let's take a round and see the other walls in engine. Angle pe hai, 90 degrees angle. This is also an angle ball, right? These are made up of bronze. These are not cast iron balls. These are bronze balls. Along with that, the rating is written over here. The PN25, DN50. Right guys? Not just that. Now there is a big difference you got to know. See, a globe ball can be a non-written ball or it can be a simple globe ball. Now this ball is a simple globe ball. So when we open or close the ball opens or closes. There is nothing over here. How we know? From the spindle over here. Come upar dikha. This is just a dot over here. So this is a normal globe ball. But this ball is different. It has got on the spindle a cut over here. Normally it's a cross like this or it's a cut. Now this is a globe ball, but this is a non-return ball. Guys, in this, the spindle and your ball are not attached together. So even if when the ball was lifted, it is in open condition. Right now, the ball is in shut condition. Only when the pump starts and water starts going from here, through the pressure from here, this ball is going to lift and water is going to go over there. Kapil, come, let's go down. Guys, this is a quick closing ball. I have already explained you that in my video. This is a quick closing ball. All the fuel oil tanks, lube oil tanks are fitted with quick closing balls. Immediately, they just shut down. Butterfly balls over here. Now, butterfly balls have got another capacity. Why a globe ball is not fitted and a butterfly ball is fitted over here? Because butterfly balls are easy to operate, cheaper, compact size. See, if I had to put a globe ball over here, it would have required this much space. A butterfly ball comes in this much space itself. So that's why butterfly balls are used. But butterfly balls are normally of two types. One is worm gear wheel type. When I rotate this, a gear rotates inside, it rotates another gear which rotates the spindle of the shaft over here. And the ball opens or closes. But we also have a different kind of a ball. This is a butterfly ball over here. And as you have to operate from, this is a lever provided over here. So we open this lock mechanism and we operate this ball and adjust this. So this is the butterfly ball. Okay. Now guys, what is this? This is a globe ball, angle, rating is given over here, and another thing. See, this has got a cross over here on the spindle. See, this has got a cross. Right? So this is a non-return globe angle ball with the rating given over here. See, here 125 because this is a big ball. I will show you that here is 250. So that will be a bigger ball. Come. Okay guys, I am standing in the compressed air system area where I have got air bottles over here. Now see, this is a glow ball. It's a normal glow ball. No cross over here. It's a straight ball. TN125, bigger ball. So TN125. Since it's a 30 bar line, 30 bar is the pressure. Because straight compressed air goes to 30 bar. Apart from that, we have got a relief ball fitted over here. Suppose someday what happens is the compressor does not cut off. Then air bottle will get pressurized. And once it is 32 bar, this relief ball will lift and air will release. Once the pressure comes down, it will come back again. Very cheap ball. Okay. Similarly, relief ball is fitted in controller side. Not just that. See guys over here. We have got relief balls fitted pressure reducing valve is very very important. See what is happening is 30 bar air from the compressed air line is going to the main engine. But we do not require that compressed air for all the compressed air lines in the system. Why? Because if we give 30 bar air, the air line needs to be very very sturdy, very strong. A lot of cost is going to be required. और जब हमारा काम 30 बार से नहीं चाहिए साथ में चलते तो why do we require 30 bar pressure, right? So what we do is we put reducing valve over here. What they do is see, come over here. Right now the pressure coming from here is 2.5 MPa. That is 25 bars. But from here it goes to this reducing valve and the pressure comes to 7 bars over here. This is being done by this pressure reducing valve. In case if I have to adjust the pressure, I will have to adjust the spring tension over here. If I loosen it, the pressure overall will reduce. If I tighten it, the pressure overall will increase. And in any case, someday this malfunctions. If we wanted the 25 bar to become 7 bar, but suppose it is becoming 10 bars. So what we have got a safety over here. This relief valve will automatically lift and release the air over here, so that the other line, which is at a lower pressure rating of lower pressure, should not get damaged. Copy it, guys? Now, see the difference. These walls are made up of cast iron. This valve over here is made up of brass. So accordingly, we need to find out different material, different kind, depending on working pressure, working temperature. Jai Mata Di. Guys, one of the walls that I was talking about was ball valve. Ball valve हमारे घर में भी लगा होता है बहुत जगह पे. Where we see a cock fitted in a water line and we just shut it like this. That's a ball valve. Open it yourself at home and you'll get an idea. On board ship, we have got ball valves over here. Ball valves are simply put on those lines where either you have to keep the valve open or shut. You don't have to regulate the flow. या बंद या open. If you have to close, 90 degrees over here, the valve will shut. If we have to open, keep it like this in the direction of the line. The ball valve is in open condition when it is in the direction of the flow. If you are doing like this, you are closing the ball. Copy it, guys? Remember that. Come. Another kind of valve that I was talking about was needle valve. Needle valve, in jagah where we are used, where we need very, very, what do we say the word here? Accurate flow, actually very very accurate flow. So your pressure gauges line mein all these balls are needle balls fitted over here. When you open this ball, you see it's a needle type. The seating is very small, very fine flow, very calibrated flow. Wherever required, you need a needle ball over there. Always remember that. Now guys, I'm standing here PWTS, Ballast Water Treatment System. This is big line, this is huge line. You can see guys over here, huge line. So these lines have got balls. Bigger the ball, bigger the power you require to open or close, right? So what we do is, in case of automation we want, if we want less people on board ship, we want more automation on board ship as well. So what we do is, we have got this big ball. What we do is, we have made the system such a way that since that we just have to press a button from engine control room or ECR and this ball will automatically operate. How? Hydraulic oil, over here, air is coming. 6 bar air is coming and getting over here. Jo bhi butterfly valves mein rehte hain, they can be either air operated or hydraulically operated. Hydraulic oil operated. I'll show you those valves as well. So what happens is, yahan se 6 bar ki air aake yahan par wait kar rahi hai. These are solenoid valves fitted over here. What happens is, when you say, oh, valve open, say this solenoid valve opens and air from here goes inside over here. There is a piston and it presses the piston that side. Accordingly, the valve opens. Because the piston is linked with the gear over here. So when this piston rotates, piston moves translatory, it accordingly rotates the gear and the valve opens. Accordingly, when you have to shut, this solenoid valve opens, air from here goes from to that side of the piston, pushes the piston over here, accordingly the gear rotates in opposite direction and valve shuts. Got it, guys? Not just that, I'll show you another kind of valve. It is also a butterfly valve. It is a big huge valve. And when the valves become huge, then air itna kaam nahi kar pata. Air just 6 bar pressure, right? Over there you need higher pressure, 50 bars, 100 bar pressure. So what we operate wall, this is huge wall, right? So, agar yahan par se, if it would have been having a lever over here to for a chief engineer like me who is a 65 kg weight to operate, bandwidth levers, nahi kar payega, difficult. All I have to do is today, hydraulically operate, I've got a hydraulic pump over here. What I do is, I've got a lever, I put a lever over here, I put it in open-close direction, and then I pump. So what happens is, when I'm pumping with this lever over here, yahan par laga ke I pump, there's a hydraulic pump, it sends the oil to either direction, over here to this piston or to this piston. Now when this piston moves, there is a gear inside over here, this gear turns and accordingly it opens or closes this big valve. Not just that guys, we can operate this valve not just locally but also from remote. That's a complete different subject that I'm going to talk about. Got it guys? Jai Mata Di. Okay guys, now what kind of valve is this? This is a ball valve. Tuck open, tuck close. Jai Mata Di. Now guys, I have shown you butterfly valve. What is this? यहाँ पर कोई वॉल नहीं दिख रहा मुझे. Why? Because this is a swing check wall. What do you mean by swing check wall? See, this line is going overboard. ये बाहर जा रहा है पानी. And always, when outside there always going to be a pressure, say 1 bar, 0.5 bar, depending on whether the ship, how much water level is there above the bottom of the ship over here. So we do not want water to come inside over here. So this is a swing check valve fitted over here. It has got a flap like this, flap. Iske andar sirf ek flap hai. So when water is coming from here, tuck, open and it lets the flow go there. But as soon as pressure over here drops and pressure over this side increases, just shut this flap. Shuts. So no flow comes inside. It's a non-return valve, swing check valve. Swing, swinging like a pendulum. But always trying to open in one direction, otherwise shuts like this. Jai Mata Di guys, this is a mono screw sludge pump. It's a positive displacement pump. Any positive displacement pump is going to have a relief valve fitted. See, this is a relief valve fitted over here. Now, agar mujhe iska pressure release karna, I have to open this and there is going to be a nut over here which if I tighten, the opening pressure will increase and if I loosen it, the opening pressure will decrease depending on how, whether I am compressing the spring or releasing the spring tension. So in case, what happens is, if in case we shut the discharge valve, what will happen? The pressure is going to increase over here. So that if pipe does not burst, or this line does not burst, or this pump does not get damaged, automatically discharge time this valve is going to lift, and the oil or water from here is going to go back into the suction side. This is the suction side. So that is how a positive displacement is safeguarded. Jai Mata Di. Jai Mata Di guys, I have talked about so many gate wall, flow wall, all those walls. I am also going to talk about a different wall, that is a three-way wall. See, normally ye wall kaisa hai, connected between over here, two lines. But this is a different, unique wall. It is connected three sides. Over here, over here, over here. And we do not have anything to regulate because the wall is being regulated by this controller over here. And this controller is getting signal from the temperature setting for main engine jacket water that we have made. So what happens is, main engine se jo paani aa raha hai, the water that is coming, it is going over here. Now we have said say, we want main engine jacket water to be at 80 degrees or 85 degrees. Accordingly, this valve is going to operate and regulate, ensuring that main engine jacket water outlet temperature is 85 degrees. It will either send it to the cooler or bypass the cooler. Got it guys? Jai Mata Di. Jai Mata Di guys. Guys, this is a gate valve over here. How do I know what gate valve? You can see the pump. It is very thin over here. So, it's going to be gate either laga hai. It either opens or closed. It is not required for where the flow has to be regulated. If you want to keep it 20% open, 40% open. No. Either fully open or fully closed. Normally, when we are using valves at a pressure, at a place where it is very high temperature, like in case of boiler or steam, we never use butterfly valve. Why? Because butterfly valves have got gasket, rubber packing fitted over here, which usually gets damaged at such a high temperature. So over there, we either use a globe valve or a gate valve. Jai Mata Di.